Hello, I am Jamily Youngblood, and I am joined with author Jennifer Youngblood here on the beautiful BYU Hawaii campus.
Hello.
We're in Hawaii because BYU Hawaii actually did a play that you wrote over a decade ago. Can you tell us a little bit about that play?
Yes, this was a dream come true to be able to come here and see this play performed. I wrote it about a dear friend of mine. Her name is Sela Fanga, and she and her husband Hanga lived in Tonga, and they got called on a mission. And they only had like 3 or 4 days notice to get ready. They had to sell everything they had. And they ended up getting called to this remote island called Fotoa'a, which is basically just a big rock in the middle of the ocean with, mm-hmm. with no harbor, no beaches. And they ended up taking this boat to get there. It took them a month to get there because the weather was so bad. Yeah. And they had a 5-month-old baby whose name is Sina, and she's actually a good friend of mine, but they ended up having to throw her up on the island to get her up there. So that's what the play is about.
You actually were a student here at BYU Hawaii. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yes. So I came here right out of high school and came from Alabama, and it was pre-internet, so you really couldn't go research anything. Uh-huh. And it was just amazing to be here. I felt like I was on this beautiful adventure. It was really fun, but I really enjoyed getting to know all the different students because there's so much diversity here. And it just opened my eyes up to all the different cultures and different ways of life that I had experienced.
Mm-hmm. Can you tell us a little bit about how you came to write Sela's story?
Yes, so when I actually ended up coming back here, and when I was in my mid-30s, mm-hmm. and I actually came with my husband and my 2 sons, and we finished our degrees here. And so for my senior project, I had to do something really big mm-hmm. to graduate. But I wanted to do something that, not just to fill that requirement, but something that would live on. And I wanted to use my writing skills. I kind of was in this kind of interesting situation where I had already had 2 novels published mm-hmm. by the time I came here, and then I'm writing essays and term papers again.
Right. So it was student kind of, all over
yeah,
again.
It was, so mm-hmm. it was kind of an interesting juxtaposition, but I wanted to do something that I felt like would be lasting. And then I was trying I wanted to write a play, and I was trying to find something to write about, but I also wanted it to have something to do with the Hawaiian culture, mm-hmm. or the Polynesian culture, I should say. But then Patrick, my husband, some people that we went to church with, who happened to be some of our dear friends, she had given a talk in church, and she was Sina, the baby. Mm-hmm. And she talked about how her parents were called on a mission and how that she was thrown up on this cliff to get up on the island. And so Patrick, was sick the day that Sina spoke in church, and so Patrick came home and said, "Jen, I think I found your story." Mm-hmm. And so through that, I was already good friends with Sela Fanga, that she was the woman who actually it happened to. But then our relationship grew even stronger because she told me her story, and that's kind of how the play unfolded.
That's amazing. To learn more about Sela's story, you can get a copy of the play Into the Light at jenniferyoungblood.com.
And it's free, so be sure and download it.